It is Belmont. It is Lopez Radio on Twitch. Carrion, how you doing, buddy?
Good to see you.
Hope you guys are doing all right tonight. We're going to play some Bramble. Rambling. made a big old garbage plate for Din-Dins. What's a garbage plate? Just whatever's in the fucking fridge? Just a bunch of leftovers? What goes into a garbage plate? Sushi rice and whatever is in the freezer I need to eliminate. Mexican street corn, green beans, breaded scrimps. Breaded scrimps, really? Well, numb. Num nummy num num. Twitch is weird. Twitch is fucking weird. I also got some steak strips accidentally, but maybe not accidentally, and water chestnuts. Wound up being kind of like a surf and turf garbage plate. Sounds good. Hot tub weird. I'm just, all right, let's see. Just like this, whatever crown is. 14,000 people. I think this is definitely pre-recorded content, right? So essentially it's a YouTube channel, a YouTube video that they're just playing live. Hey guys, want a motorboat, some titties? Close the door. Might just close the door there. Before I start yelling motorboat and titties, and my wife's gonna come down and be like, what? It's not the strangest thing I've seen. Yeah, I've seen weirder shit. It's interesting. Shit's interesting, man. How are 1.3K people watching the finals? Is the finals still going? I thought the playtest was over. I thought it was over. Today I've been doing meals based on fridge clearing and also breakfast burritos. What'd y'all have for dinner, Sean? What was your dinner like? By the way, anyone going to Nashville, go to Bearded Iris. Bearded Iris. Home style, baby. Home style. Such a good IPA. Had a big lunch today, so I haven't really eaten anything. Oh. All damn. What up, Midwest? How are you? Went over to Buford Highway today and got some legit Mexican. Oh, shit. I haven't been over to the Buford Highway area in a minute. I need to go back over there with my dad. He's got a spot that does Peruvian Chinese food. Oh! It'll make you jizz them panties, baby. You will jizz all in your white boy panties. Mid, how's your day going? How's the fam? So we started Bramble last night. And man, what a combination. Scratches all them itches. Yeah, we got to go after the dickhead troll again. We're going to fuck that troll up. Little man had tubes in his ears and tonsils and adenoids out. Oh, no. Is he all right? I have a feeling my kid's going to have to get that done. She will have to probably get that done at some point. I had to get it done. It'll keep him from getting sick, man. We're fucking a troll. Trying to fuck Karen. He's taking it like a champ. That's awesome. Glad he's taking it like a champ. Because in anime, everything's hot. We're going to fuck that troll up. Holy shit. Holy shit. We were just talking about you. Last night, I was just talking about, I wonder how Mod's doing, and I probably need to check on him. Well, there he is, everyone. 40 months. Thank you for the prime, buddy. I hope things are going good, dude. We legit were actually talking about you last night. Thank you for the 40 months, brother. Mr. Fellers just got the PC set up. Thanks for thinking about the little old me. Hope you and the wife and the child you get were good, man. We're good. Living the life, man. Living that life. Working, hanging out, playing games when I can. It's good to see you. I hope things are well. I'm honestly looking forward to the finals. I want to play it pretty bad. The playtest was going on as I was being sick and coming off of Vegas and, just kind of dealing with a bunch of other shit. I didn't get to play as much. I didn't get to play at all. I actually installed it, but I never even, like, fucking played. Man, I'm happy to be here. Keep it kind of chill tonight. Do a little Bramble. Hang out a little bit. What up, Tina? That OG beanie drip, no less. Dude, the bioweapon, baby. The bioweapon. It's back live in the merch store. So who was it? Did Lord Almond buy three of those the other night? I think he bought all three colors. Sergeant Sexy. Kane. How's it going, Kane? He bought two or three, didn't he? There's three colors available. I think he bought all three colors. Things are getting better. Bought a complete remodel for my first house. Did about 95% of the work myself. Got the whole upstairs redone and almost done. Shit, man. Congrats, dude. That's fucking huge. Got the upstairs bathroom left. Then the whole basement. You're gonna fucking make a kick-ass basement. Kick-ass finished basement. Sarge, brother. Hope you're doing all right, man. Hope things are good. Playing some 7 Days to Die. Was it 7 Days to Die that was at, they were at TwitchCon. Yeah, they were at TwitchCon hanging out. I don't know, not sure yet. Really nice neighborhood. But a small house, hey man, the basement's the best way to fucking make that house feel bigger on the inside. So we got two rooms now. Actually, we got two rooms, and we did a playroom for the kid downstairs, man. Fucking love it. It's basically zombie survival that's been in EA for years. Yeah, they had a big display. They had a big booth at, they must be getting ready to go full release with it. Do I own that? I don't even know if I own that. I think someone bought it for me. The devs are fun pimps, dude. They were, they had big crowds. That's for sure. I don't think I have 7 days to die. I know Nameology and Living Dead Girl play it from time to time. Yeah, I don't think I have it. 7 Enhanced Edition. People love that game though. Oh, I do have it. Oh Christ. It's already in my Steam library. I don't know where I got it from. Looks like LDG and Nameology are playing some Ark Survival Evolved. What is this? What's happening here? Tell me about this. What's happening here? Can you see zombie titties in this game? Are there zombie titties in this game to be seen? Fuckery of the prostitute variety. There is fuckery afoot. There is fuckery afoot. Oh, what the hell, man? There's a strip club building. Oh, my God. You're going to make me play this game, aren't you? You're going to make me play this game, aren't you? It came out in 2013, and it's still in early access? Is this really a 10-year early access game? Is that the meme? What up, Groody? Come for the zombie killing. Stay for the white girl titties. I mean, you sold me. You sold me. You had me at white girls. I mean, you had me at hello. 10-year early access. That is the earliest access I've ever seen in my life. God, that's funny. God, that's hilarious. That is fucking crazy talk. Oh, white girls, you say? It's kind of a known thing around here. Around these parts, white girls have admiration, adoration. When the game is going great, they fuck it up and remake the entire game. Really? Is that what they do? Every new patch? If you're being offered titties, you want to see them. It's like Costco samples. Fair, fair. Groody, what are you guys getting into tonight? You guys hunting? You guys out there in the bayou? You bayou? Bayou billin'? Bayou boobin'? Bayou bojangling? The dinger is now sick with what I had, so not so much. Aw. What'd you have? Did you have the COVIDs, or did you just have some flus or some respiratory thingies? Basically, after people find the cheese to surviving, they change the system. Last few, they improved zombie pathing to make some base styles not work super great anymore. We a sick house with the flu. Oh, God. I'm sorry. Just sick, so I get sick. Try playing some Robin Curb Swamping. I am no longer the archer I once was. Dude, the game has changed a fucking lot since me and you played. Back in the mod Curbs days, it's a very different game now. A new person every other day. Only two more left to get it. They're just counting. They're just sitting there scratching lines on the wall. I've survived 7 days. 4 out of 6. Dun, dun, dun. Coming next week. Body aches. Chills. You might be shitting yourself. You'll definitely be coughing. It's the flu. What a BD. Baseball bats probably do some extra damage to horses. The bats are fun. The bats are really fun. The player base has grown so much, man. You just, and the talent pool within the bayou has gone up a lot. So you get a lot of squashes. But then you have some nights where you're just fucking owning everything. It's just weird. Ah, a slugger of the Groodyville variety. I know I was getting smoked the last 3 games I played. Yeah, it's getting pretty hairy out there, man. Hairy as hell. What else you been playing, mod? Did you fuck with the finals at all when it was in playtest? I think the finals is going to be the new jam, the new jammy jam. I'm still enjoying the shtick in the in-game, getting some giggles from people. You just got to make that sound every time you hit play. Home run. Just set up my computer for the first time in like 8 months, about a week ago. Damn, son. You been that busy, huh? Just fucking working like a madman and passing out. It's like when Lopez chased one of our non-regulars with our now regulars with a shovel. Oh yeah, shovel's coming. Shovel's coming. I chased that guy all over the place. Disingenuous T-Rex. Oh, that's right, there it is. I played one game of CSGO and logged into RuneScape. Stood at the bank for 10 minutes, then logged off. Oh yeah, for sure. For sure. I'll check them out. Sometimes the view is all you need. Sometimes, dude. Well, now I'm kind of intrigued by 7 days today. I wonder how long I've had this. Does it tell me how long I've had it in my library? Did someone gift this to me? Was it Namie and them? A lot of people play it. A lot of people on my friends list play it. Info. I have no idea how to even see any of that. Oh, the Chucky gameplay is pretty fucking funny. Let me see if I can find a why is this the way it is? Why are you the way that you are? There are so many things that I don't like about you. All right, let's see. If you're missing any, oh, here we go. Okay, I found it. I knew Morph would have it. All right, here we go. Hang on, let me pause this. Pals, and here we go. Here is the Chucky Mori, if you're ready.
Better be good. Bonk. No. Whoa. Jesus.
Die already.
The little kick in the ass.
Die already. Holy shit.
Better be good.
How brutal that is.
Bonk. No. Whoa. Jesus.
Die already.
Holy shitballs. That's so good.
That's so good.
Oh, yeah. The voice line's random, and it changes every Maury. He talks a lot during the match, too. Talks a lot of shit. I love it. Man, I'm all about it. Oh, they got him to do the voice acting? The laugh sounded spot on, at least? I mean, it's him. It's the guy. That explains why it sounds so spot on. That explains the spot-onedness. Explains a lot. Put that in the Discord. I know we don't play it anymore, but, man, you can definitely enjoy some sweet clips from it. Some of those sweet, sweet clips. Still a dead game? I mean, I don't know about that. Let's see. Steam charts. It's just dead in your eyes. Current players, 33,690. Let's compare that to Hunt Showdown with a whopping 12,235. Fortnite's a dead game too, but people still play it for some dick-butted reason. I'll die on the hill. When did someone tell Google Messages it should let me know when I'm a piece of shit friend? What happened? What happened? Google's getting good at shit, man. Google's getting real good at shit. You received a message below. Text says, you received this 3 days ago and you haven't responded. I know, asshole. I don't want to respond. Oh, my God. There's got to be a way to turn that off. You only play on the rare occasion? I don't know. I haven't touched it in a long time. It's been a long time. Don't they have you can get bots now. Like you can actually set up a lobby of bots and they're actually not too bad to go up against, apparently. A lobby of butts. That's right. You heard right, Sean. A lobby of butts. An entire lobby of white butts. Yes, it's all Tina just running around. Hey, Midnight Ghost Hunt has 22 people playing it right now. That's plus 1.8 on a 30-day gain. A whole 22? It's like a herd of cattle or a murder of crows. A lobby of butts. Okay, I'm back. Someone said butts. Or a subreddit of hipsters. What do you call a gathering of hipsters? A subreddit. That's funny. What I want to know is how 22 people, if there's actually 22 people playing Midnight Ghost Hunt, or if there's just like that many people that have left that game on and like never come back to their PC. 27 people died while logged into it. Never logged out again. I call it the coloring pixel. They've just been on, like the main screen is just burnt into their LED monitor. Where if you turn it off, you still can read everything. Loads up MGH. Takes a 4-month vacation to Istanbul. They're just slumped over at their computer. Game is so bad. They just couldn't even go forward with it anymore. Their brain just shut off. Istanbul, Constantinople, Istanbul, Constantinople. Even old New York was once New Amsterdam. And there's the They Might Be Giants trap set. Fucking love it. You know what I think about, though? Do you remember that Tiny Toons did the Istanbul, Constantinople? Do you remember when they did that? Sounds like an Animaniacs guess, but... But the people who did Tiny Toon Adventures ended up being the people in Animaniacs. Babs and Buster Bunny were Yakko and Dot. What up, Faye? Oh, this is a fucking throwback. Throwback. I'm gonna go get a drink.
Liked it better that way.
So take me back to Constantinople. No, you can't go back to Constantinople. Been a long time gone. Constantinople, why did Constantinople get the works? That's nobody's business but the Turks. Istanbul.
Man, I watched the shit out of Tiny Toons.
Maybe
liked it better that way.
Istanbul was Constantinople, now it's Istanbul and Constantinople. Then Constantinople, why did Constantinople get the works?
That's a banger. Tiny Toons is the fucking best. Tiny Toons and Animaniacs were like my fucking jam. Elmira. The worst possible reward.
Istanbul.
Bam. Okay, wait a minute. Why is this a thing? Vanilla Ice reacts to Ice Ice Baby. Oh, the Vanilla Ice YouTube channel. Vanilla Ice reacts to all the money he made in a short period of time. I watched it. No shame. Take heed because he's a lyrical pro and. Take heed because I'm a lyrical pro and. I know, he definitely did. And then he was absolutely adamant that he didn't rip off Queen and David Bowie. Ding 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 ding. See, that's the difference in mine.
I'm so stupid.
I would have giggled all the way to the bank. I mean, fuck yeah, man. Dude, I'm not saying I didn't listen to it. I'm just thinking it's weird. Like, it's very Bo Burnham of him to be reacting to his own shit. It's not like it was some random demo tape they found and they were like, hey, let's listen to this demo tape that's cringy and douchey. It's like a smash hit that so many people have seen. How many views that video got? Do you remember in the In Living Color, Ice Ice Baby, Jim Carrey? Oh, God, dude. I watched In Living Color so much as a kid. So much. Let's see how many views it's got. Probably too many. Vanilla Ice Ice Baby. All right, let's see. 1 million views. 1 million views in 2 weeks. But the actual video, 517 million views. Think he got demonetized for his own song? Probably. We old? And live in color. You can't do what you wanna do. And live in color. Homie the Clown? Fire Marshal Bill? Two snaps up in a circle? Come on. I watched the shit out of that. Oh, fucking Martin? Oh, yeah. Hell yeah, dude. OG J-Lo, Fly Girl. Martin. Homie, don't play that. That's for sure. Homie the Clown. I watched the shit out of Martin, too. I got in trouble in PE class for saying damn Gina over and over again to myself. Asgroot typed that in chat. I was just talking to myself. I was like, damn Gina. Oh, and I absolutely had to go run laps for that. Oh, man. Young Fat Lopez did not enjoy the laps he had to run because of Martin. Oh, God. Shaniqua. There was Shaniqua and there was Shanaynay. Where was Shanaynay from? Was Shanaynay in Living Color? Shanaynay was Jamie Foxx, wasn't it? Shanaynay was Jamie Foxx on In Living Color, wasn't it? God, how great. How great. Look how bad the quality of this is.
Yo, VIP, let's kick it.
Look at Jim Carrey.
All right, stop. While I do up my laces, this kind of thing happens every show. Yo, I gotta learn how to tie a bow.
What's your real name?
Robert Van Winkle.
Why did you change?
Nothing rhymes with Winkle. Huh? Oh, yeah. I'm white.
Nothing rhymes with Winkle. Shanaynay was Martin. Wanda was Jamie Foxx. Shanaynay was Martin. You're right.
Maybe never. I become richer with every endeavor. I'm living large and my bank is stupid because I just listen to real rap and dupe it.
And dupe it. So very white, baby.
I'm a little teapot, short and stout.
Damn near a Weird Al song.
I told the world I was stabbed in the butt, but it was a toilet paper cut. Yeah!
fucking so weird, man. We had the best shows. Married with Children? Anyone Married with Children? Fucking love Married with Children. And it's still weird for me to see Ed O'Neill in Modern Family. Pop culture.
What's up?
Pop culture comedy is always weird. Years later, it is.
Yo, I ain't stupid. I just stupid.
Definitely iconic. Dude, I watch so much Married with Children. I watch so much Cheers. I watch so much of that shit. Ridiculous. Speaking of iconic, oh my God.
I would rather talk about
one of the best movies ever made. Yeah, that was the Al Bundy show.
It's cute, Delia.
It's cute, Delia. Fucking Otho, baby. R.I.P. We should film this? God.
Otho, are you doing
work
this?
Work all night on a drink of rum. Stack banana till the morning come.
Daylight come and me one go home.
And Living Color, Kids in the Hall, Whitest Kids You Know. Yeah, those are good ones.
Daylight come and me one go home. Come, Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana.
Daylight come and me one go home.
Live
6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot bunch.
Daylight come and me one go home.
Catherine O'Hara is the fucking best, too. National treasure. National fucking treasure. I imagine it's probably hard to keep a straight face, like, filming anything with Michael Keaton or Catherine O'Hara.
Hide the deadly black tarantula.
Yeah, she's in Schitt's Creek. The best. The best. I'm telling you. Man, Cuban Pete. Ah, the king of the rumba beat. Oh my God. We could sit here all night and do that. Yeah, she's the mom from Schitt's Creek. She's also in one of my other favorite movies, Best in Show. She's also the mom in Home Alone. I kind of can't believe Gunship got Gavin Rosdale for a song. Girls forgetting Kevin every day. Curdy can play the Catherine O'Hara part. Dude, if we could get Curdy to cosplay as Catherine O'Hara from that scene with the hair doing the thing on the side, that'd be fucking amazing. I'm sending her the picture. I'm sending it to her right now. Like, this is your next cosplay. All right, here we go. I'll say, chat agrees that this is the only cosplay we want to see from you. Boom. It's sent. I've planted the seed. If it happens, I get the fucking credit. I did this. Actually, Sean did this. I facilitated. Sean was the idea man. Watch, she's going to pop in here. Watch this. I'll be Otho. She just sent back, what the fuck? LOL. This would be an amazing cosplay. This is the one. Why? Why not? It's perfect. It's fucking perfect. This is my new, like, still image when I don't want to use cam. It's just going to be down in the bottom. But how? How do things happen here, Curdy? You understand this, right? You understand that we have no idea how we got here. How did this even come to you? Listen, I don't know. No, here's what we did. We were watching a bunch of random shit, and then this was on as one of the suggested videos after a video, and we watched it, and then Sean said we should record this as a group, and Curdy could be Catherine O'Hara. And I was like, all right, well, there it is. And I was like, I'm gonna message her right now. And I did. This would be a dynamite fucking cosplay. One black gloves all the way up to the bicep, whatever this fucking thing is, some crazy dangly things on your ears, and then it's got to be the fucking squiggly lines. Life imitates art, imitates life, imitates art. We did kind of get here from Ice Ice Baby. That is the lifeline, by the way. Guys are weirdos. What? Everybody thinks it's amazing. You calling us all weirdos? Are you calling Groody a weirdo? You calling Squirf a weirdo? Tina? Are we calling Tina a weirdo? Oh, Kane? Kane's a weirdo? I know you're not calling Carrion one. Come on. How did we get here? I just love the what the fuck LOL. You're never far from our minds, Curdy. Just remember that. Carrie's the most normal person in this channel. Honestly, hanging out, like if we were all to be hanging out in a fucking group, my wager is on Carrie and is probably the calm, collected one. No comment. Carrion, also no comment. I'm the one confused. Tina, have you seen Beetlejuice? 9, 8, 7, 5, 4, 3. Blasphemous pickles. Sean is convinced I grew up under a rock. Mom! Man. I would much rather talk about... Deo. I just need to see Curdy do that. Deo. No, it's fine. It's fine. I understand. Look, I also understand I'm getting to an age where like all the movies and TV shows I loved, there's a lot of people that I talk to that have never watched them or seen them or knew about them. Assholes. Assholes. Assholes made me dress like this. A handful of assholes in a small ass chat made me dress like this way today. See, you can do it. She could do it. She could write a song about us, a parody song about us. Fire. Doubt fire. Asshole Kong 2024. That's what we need to film next in the next AC. I really do want to do like a Halloween thing with the group sometime. One of these days, you know? One of these days. Group Halloween costume be fucking rad. Oh, did you see the fucking Thriller thing? The Thriller dance that happened this past... Halloween, the NYC Halloween parade. No, that was not that one. Oh, the New York City Halloween parade. Did you see that shit? Hey, Sean, you saw Death is going to be at DreamHack this year. I'm actually going to take my kid one of the days. I think I got a stream slot. I think I managed to get a stream slot. I don't know if Curdy and Eric are going to make it for it. But if they do, I'm halfway tempted just to let Curdy stream in my slot. Just to let her stream during my time. And be like, I'll just be stream coach the whole time. I'd be like, I'll just have a fucking microphone just talking to chat while she's playing. Hey, everybody, what she's doing right now is picking up shit. A Halloween asshole Kong? That would be great, right? Look, you would actually do more good than me streaming at DreamHack. You're going to go to Seattle? You're going to catch the fish at the fish market? Or is that Boston? What am I thinking about? Who cares? He will be working most of the time. Fucking boo, man. Get somebody to come up there with you. Faye, Faye, Faye. Think David's in Seattle? David? Well, that'll be fun. I mean, I'm not going to say I'm not hurt you're not coming, but I understand. I get it. I understand. I get it. Your mom's coming down the week of DreamHack? Oh, you'll have fun. You'll have a good time. It is very close. Yeah, I know. It's very close to fucking holidays, and I was kind of confused by that. I'm honestly surprised that I convinced the wife to bring the kid one day. It's good. I'm going to talk. I guess I'll talk to Death and see if, and maybe, I don't know. I don't know if I can. Like, I'm not a hunt partner, so I would say I'd fucking play hunt. And give some shit away while I was there. But Death would have a better chance than me at that, right? Any of you hunt folks out there, 60% off. They aren't accepting Death as a creator. Well, he'll still be there, though. He could still talk to other streamers. Like, so he will have a creator badge, and he can go into the creator lounge. He could actually network the game a little bit. He was saying he thinks they passed on him. I don't think they did. They don't pass on anybody. They don't pass on anybody. Why would they pass on him? I don't believe that. I told him to message the guy. Last time I talked to him, which was like yesterday, he was like, I just haven't heard anything. I was like, just fucking message him. Let him know. You're local. You're a partner. He's still within the window. Like they don't stop taking the applications for another 2 weeks. They don't stop taking the applications for another 2 weeks. He'll be fine. He'll be in. He just got to fucking figure it out. I think honestly yours went through because I said something like right away. Like I was messaging Bear, the guy who heads it all up, as you were filling your application out. So that's probably why yours went through so quick. He'll get in. He'll be fine. He should just stand outside their office with a boombox. Hey, the guy that you who was the guy you talked to at Beacon, by the way? Was it Torben? Did you talk to Torben? I would like to come down, but I didn't realize Eric was going to Seattle. Then my mom. Torben was the one that didn't I send you over to them to put your name in to talk to, and he completely ghosted you? Oh shit. Oh yeah, that was the fucking random Discord I sent you to and said, hey, they want to talk to Beacon people. He used to be the DreamHack guy. Do you want me to tweet him live? Hey, why don't you write back, motherfucker? No, Torben's nice dude. Bear who took over for him is really nice too. The DreamHack folks are pretty fucking good. Yeah, I don't know. That's very weird that they agreed to a partnership with you, you know? You smelly fuck knuckle. Fuck Knuckles, a good one. Not gonna lie. Interesting. Well, who we fighting? All the boys at Beacon. We're gonna brawl. We're gonna pull out our steel toe boots and go to town. 3 p.m. at the flagpole. You know it. Fucking lace them bitches up tight. Bring your wallet chain. What exactly is a fuck knuckle? Tina, I know you're sheltered, buddy, but think about it. I like, what exactly is a fuck knuckle? J-Pod! Are you calling J-Pod a fuck knuckle? They're the backwards cousins of twat waffles. I mean, I'm honored. I am your fuck knuckle in chief. J-Pod knuckle. Let's talk about this for a second. J-Pod, how do you feel about this as a curdy cosplay? A curdy cosplay, J-Pod. Is that not an amazing idea? Kurt's play, if you will. Get on it. Log on it, dog on it. She thinks we're weirdos. She has a tough time believing that she's close at mind at all times with this group. It's my Kurt's doom. We are the best weirdos. Gunship Fox, dude, this Gunship album is lit hits. Lit hits. As if she called us weirdos was a bad thing. As if she called us weirdos knowing she's not part of this group. The curse is taking hold. She calls herself a weirdo. That's right. We are what she feels she is. I'm cool with it. I'm cool with it. I'm fine with it. Man, how did we get here? Oh, I know who did it to us. It's fucking Rob Van Winkle. Rob fucking Van Winkle. Oh. Oh. Oh, did you guys watch the Ghostbusters Frozen Empire trailer? Did it happen? Did you watch it? Did you see it? Oh, yeah. J-Pop, we were talking about 22 people right now are playing Midnight Ghost Hunt. And that's a plus 1.3 players over the last 30 days. 22 people. That's got to be a terrible feeling. Like, in all honesty, I know those devs worked hard and they were very nice. I met them at PAX. It's got to be such a fucking bummer, man. It's got to be such a bummer. Yeah, that was the pirate ship game. They really did try. They did. Well, I mean, there's a pirate ship map. I'm not saying it's maybe a little too much. They were working on it for a long time. A long time. We'll wait till Curdy's back, see if she wants to watch the Ghostbusters trailer with us. I sent it to her. I don't know if she watched it. People are so stuck in their games right now, nothing will get them out of it. Well, I had a shit night in Hunt last night. That snapped me out of my little fucking, my little stint with Hunt for just a hot minute. All you gotta do is have a really shitty night. Have a really shitty night in your game. It doesn't stop most people. That's true. Did you see the Chucky footage? Just continue bitching and playing. Faye, did you see the Chucky footage from DBD? Did you watch any of it? You're supposed to check out DBD with Rick. His movement makes you motion sick. Did you watch his Maury at all? His Maury's pretty good. His Maury's pretty solid. Be interested to go against him. The Trickster getting a massively overtuned buff. I don't even know who the Trickster is. I don't even know who the Trickster is. Oh, knife throwy boy. K-pop guy, right? Ah. Did you see the Maury? You have? Okay. The Maury is good. The Maury's really good. Curdy. His overall animations are fun, but he doesn't look fun at all to go against. It is kind of weird, right? Remember how long we were talking about Chucky being in the fucking game? Have you seen Naughty Bear Trapper? Naughty Bear Trapper? Please look it up on YouTube? Oh, is this a collection? Dead by Daylight collection?
Party has started without you. How dare they exclude you from all that fun? You should tell them how you really feel. No, not with your words. Try this instead. Remember, Naughty Bear, just because they wronged you doesn't mean that you shouldn't share your toy. Why shouldn't they be happy? They're free to play hide and seek forever and ever.
So dumb, yeah. Pepperidge Farm remembers I don't want it, if it doesn't say.
What time is it? It's naughty time! No, I don't think they want to play anymore. In fact, I don't think they can.
Interesting. Trapper got a buff. I do love some Trapper, not gonna lie. I heard they brought the Stranger Things fucking DLC back, inked another deal, lots of stuff. Did any of you watch Totally Killer? I gotta thank J-Pod for pointing me out pointing my attention to Totally Killer. Did anyone else watch Totally Killer? I'm just on a break for a multiplayer game, sticking with solo. Yeah, we're going to finish I think we're going to finish Bramble tonight. I don't know. I've done about an hour of Bramble. I should be able to finish it tonight. We'll see. You got about 4 hours left? Oh, we're not going to finish tonight then. We'll probably get to a couple hours tonight. Totally Killer was fun, man. It was really fun. We watched it on Halloween night. I fucking loved it. Here, I'm gonna put on the I'll put on the trailer and then I'm gonna go grab another beer. Took me about five, but I was also searching for everything. All right. Game didn't seem like it's a 5 hour game. Dude, it's a beautiful game. It's a beautiful game. All right, watch the trailer for Totally Killer. I'll be right back, and maybe Curdy will be back and we'll watch the Ghostbusters trailer together. Okay? All right.
I'd like to report a crime that hasn't happened yet. Have you seen the movie Back to the Future? Basically, I'm living that movie right now, which is how I know there's gonna be a murder tonight.
Hate time travel movies. They never make any sense.
Happy Halloween.
How about we all stay in and hand out Halloween candy?
No, Mom.
You know how hard this time of year is for us.
Your friends were murdered 35 years ago.
It's not 1987 anymore.
Stay safe, honey. I love you.
What year is it?
1987.
Oh my God. I know.
The 80s are almost over and I haven't even tried Coke yet.
I don't know.
Oh my God.
Mom.
Fuck off and die.
Jesus, Mom.
Mamacita. Ay. Ay, ay, ay. Mamacita.
Time for my birthday, bitch.
Creepy-ass cabin in the middle of fucking nowhere.
What's the big deal?
There's a murderer on the loose, and you drove us into the woods. Oh, my God!
What? I forgot to bring vodka.
You have 7.5 hours until you're stuck here forever.
I need to stop all this horror before it happens.
The machines kill us all?
No.
They more just rip apart the fabric of our society via dance videos on TikTok.
They use dance against us.
Come on out. Water's warm.
Just so you know,
I don't do blowjobs.
You pee out of that thing.
Just think, maybe if she did do blowjobs, she'd still be alive.
Yeah, let's not make that the lesson.
80s weed sucks. This is just dirt. Look at all these twigs.
Yeah, I could give you a gummy this big that has 100 times more weed than this.
It's a good'un. It's a goodie. It's a goodie. We watched it on Halloween. I convinced Curdy to watch it. She said she liked it. It's funny. My wife really enjoyed it. Oh yeah. By the way, I've already told some people. I finally told all my parents. Me and my wife are having another kid. Heads up, a baby boy Lopez is coming. Are you sure it's hers? I'm pretty sure. Pretty sure. Yeah, we're gonna have a little boy. A little boy in May. Finally told the last parent, my dad, this weekend at his retirement. So a little boy for my little girl to boss around. You stop all the fucking around New Year's. It's gonna be May. That's right. Oh yeah, my dad like was just jumping up and down. Yeah, it'll be a May baby, which I'm kind of glad both of my kids will now be on the opposite side, almost on the opposite side of the calendar from Christmas. So for the most part, mostly on the other side of the calendar. That'll be good for them. Nothing worse than like me. I have a Christmas birthday, like a birthday like a week after Christmas, you know? He's very excited. It was cool. It was cool to tell him. So my wife's just excited that she doesn't have to be pregnant through the summer this time as well. Dude, get this. My niece. Okay, so wait. My stepmother is Christmas Eve. My stepsister is Christmas Day. And then her daughter, my niece, is the 26th. How shitty is that? What? I'm always excited to never be pregnant. Nice. Yeah. Hers is the 26th as well. Yeah. I'm January 2nd. So like I'm literally a week after Christmas. So the amount of times in my life that family's been like, oh, this is for Christmas and your birthday. And I'm just like, you cheap son of a bitch. You cheap motherfucker. You don't do that to my brother in October. Your parents just kept an extra present. It says Santa on it, but it's like crossed out. Like, they did you dirty. Oh, God, they did. I still can picture my aunt's face doing it to me, too. This is for your Christmas aunt. It's the and. I think the and bothers me the most. And your birthday. And. I daydream about, like, just throat punching. This sounds terrible. I daydream about throat punching my aunt when she says and. This is for your birthday. I'd say it was double as good, but I know it wasn't. No!
Dicks.
While my sister gives her gift for her birthday, she doesn't give her shit on Christmas Day. Yeah, shit, man. Man, honestly, if I had a kid that had a birthday on Christmas or like a day to or fro from Christmas, it would be the biggest fucking celebration. It would be the biggest fucking celebration. We would have a separate birthday tree. Bro, there's so many cool things you can do with someone that has a birthday around Christmas. Like, that's touching Christmas in particular. You could fuck that shit up in a fucking awesome way. Me realizing that most people don't have left and right socks identified. All right, who marks their left and right socks? Do you actually, or are you just fucking with me? You're fucking with me? Fuck you, Carrion. Carrion. Give you a right sock and a left sock on your birthday.
Yeah, let's not talk about that tree. Come on.
I'd rather be talking about marking our left and right socks legitly. I'm not fucking with you. The old L&R. Faye, I just backs out of the room. But we can tell Lopez has thought about decorating a Christmas tree for his birthday one year, and his parents never did. Oh? He got drawings in his notebook? I mean... Oh, shit, Sarge?
Baby!
Papa Klaus. I'm going to move that. There we go. 2 years, tier two, Sarge. Love you, buddy. Thank you. I didn't even know socks. They do not. They don't come with an L and an R on them. They do not. It does not happen. Where did you buy socks from? Where? Oh, my gentle Jesus. Are there, okay, if they're toe socks, those creepy toe socks, maybe? Are there L&R socks? Also called asymmetrical fit socks, these socks are designed to fit your left and your right foot exclusively. Do left and right foot socks exist? Yes, there's a difference between left and right socks. Many socks are designed with specific fits for the left and right feet to provide added support. What? No. R/is it bullshit? Socks with R and L on them. Are they really specifically made for the right and left foot? Not bullshit. Some running socks have area of thicker fabric to prevent running / Okay, specialty socks. Oh my God. Tina, no. It's literally set up the same way as Faye's name. It's just two different words on the front. Lopez R. Cringe in the chat. Hey! She's laughing so she doesn't cry. Yeah, there you go. She's trying to outlaugh her thoughts right now. She's laughing louder than her thoughts right now. Oh, God. Curdy, did you watch the Ghostbusters trailer I sent earlier? We're about to watch it.
Live.
Listen, T-O-W is toe, but it's not that toe. It's like towing the relationship in forms of, you know, intellect, towing the relationship in forms of brain size.
My brain is broken. Broken.
Oh, my God. Tina, the Bodhi lover here. We love you, Tina. We're just fucking with you. We're just fucking with you. Can I spell this right? Let's see. All right, that's the last one. I'm sorry. I had to. Oh, Jesus Christ. All right, are we ready? He's not living any of this down. Oh, God. You have broken my brain tonight, Tina, and I love you for it. Curdy's back. We're going to watch this Ghostbusters trailer. Pause. Here we...
it's going to be another hot one out there. In fact, there are heat alerts in effect for New Jersey, feeling like 100 degrees.
First time in New York history, people froze to death in the middle of July.
What is it?
The death chill. The power to kill by fear itself. Your veins turn to rivers of ice. Your bones crack. And the last thing you see is your own tear ducts freezing up.
Like, literally scared to death?
So cool.
I'm pretty fucking pumped. Oh yeah, that's Paul Rudd. Did you watch the last one? The most recent one has Paul Rudd in it, and it's really fucking good. Really good. Afterlife is something you should watch. I'm fucking pumped. Are you asking Tina if you've seen a movie? La Mau. I'm kind of skeptical of the whole Frozen thing, but the last one is amazing, so I'll watch. Yeah, I'm gonna fucking watch the shit out of it, man. La Mau. Listen, Faye, he's a broken man. We need to be gentle with him. Yeah, you need to watch the others, for sure. For fucking sure. Me and Sean actually watched the first one, the original, on the plane on the way out to Vegas. We watched that and we watched fucking Beetlejuice. 1, 2, Afterlife, and that trailer would make more sense, yeah. The movie list is so freaking long already. Ghostbusters goes to the top. 1, 2, Afterlife, at least. A lot of people hate the one with the fucking girls, but I kind of fucking like it. But it's fine. If you don't like it. Too many references in the newest one? Yeah. It's not canon and it's bad. All right, fine. You can skip 3. Skip 3. Fine. Then play the video game. The video game's pretty good. It's pickles on a chicken sandwich. Oh, God. Put it away. It's good then. Yeah, you're outnumbered here, Carrion. Pickle me, baby. Oh, shit. All right, I wasn't ready for that. I wasn't fucking ready. What up, Sarver? Sava sauce. Good to see you, buddy. The title of your sex tape. It was the Sneaky Brows. The Sneaky Brows got me. Pickle me, baby.
Pickle me, baby, one more time.
I probably get a thirst tax for it. I don't have thirst tax. You'd have to go to Curdy's chat and pay it. Go ahead and say it. Look, I'm going to do something for you. Just for Faye. I paid the thirst tax for Faye. There it is. Done. Thirst tax paid. Curdy, all the pickles.
Oh.
Faye has broken chat, everybody. Faye has broken chat.
Oh, shit.
This is not a safe place to be. Only rebel sock wearers. If you're concerned about left and right socks, pickling's not your game, is what Curdy's saying.
Oh, God. I said I no longer have. Oh, God.
I love this chat so much. I love you guys so much. Just so you know. Just heads up. Love you too, Kane. Damn, Daniel. It's almost been 2 hours. Really a bunch of fucking HR headaches. I can get with that. All right. So, new kid coming. Told you guys that. I'm going back to school in January. Shouldn't interrupt any of our fucking fun here. But let me tell you what I'm going back to. World history. Pre or post? Pre-1450. Intro to data science. That's going to kick my ass a little bit. And then, what was the other one? Intro to IT. Lopez Radio and Curdy, the two streamers I followed first on Twitch. Curdy and I have a lot of overlap. Those are two of the best streamers. Did you know you followed two of the best streamers on Twitch? Well, let me tell you, I didn't, but now I do because Faye said so.
Bon Bon.
Look at Bon Bon behind me. Bon Bon.
Don't you want to love me? Come love me.
Look at her. She's like a cat,
Bonnie is a cat. Bonnie. She will not come to you if you want her to come. It's only when you're like, fuck you. Fine. You want to give me love? Fine. And then she's like, hey, man, what's going on? We're going to EDC in Orlando this weekend. Jesus Christ.
Bonnie.
I'm going to get this fucking dog. One second.
Well, I just fucked that up, didn't I?
Bonnie. Look how big this dog is. Look how big. What a pup a loaf. I'm alternating between two beers right now. Outlaw Mile High light beer and Bearded Iris Homestyle IPA. Like Thai, but small. Oh, yeah. That's the bonbon right there.
Bunny.
So tell me about your faves from Vegas. I mean, Abel Baker, where we went, was my favorite stop. And then, like, a couple of nights later, I went back, baby. Yeah, that place was awesome, man. But then, as far as food goes, Din Tai Fung was probably my favorite dinner. That's some dim sum right there, and it was amazing. Thanks to Curdy's husband, he fucking picked it out. They drained the water from wherever it's called. Oh, the fucking fountain show? Is it the Bellagio? Din Tai Fung. It's in the Cosmo? Oh, Curdy's husband was awesome. He's fucking great, dude. He's the best. I love that guy. I'd marry him if I could. The Venetian? Is it the Venetian where they have the fucking fountain show? Okay. Well, when we were there, the area where you would stand, it's not the fountain show for this. Oh, I know what you're talking about. Okay. So wait, like the little boats, like the fucking, weren't we there? Curdy? He is awesome. He's the fucking best. So wait, where they fucking do the fucking, and they sing, was that the Venetian? Did they drain it? Bro, we were just there. The gondolas. Yeah. Oh, they drained it. Oh, he's infected you. The Bellagio is the fountains. Yeah, when we were there, so when we were coming in, we noticed that they had built grandstands and fucking box suites for the F1 race on the sidewalk where you stand and watch the Bellagio fountain. Formula One grandstands. Oh, Christ. Can you imagine how much money would have to be coming in for them to just fuck everything up? This one's going to be the viewing platform. Oh, Curdy, I bet that's right there in that fucking raised area where we were standing near the fucking VR place. The fucking bridge that goes over right there. I bet it's that. Aren't they like, and they're going to be there for the next 4 or 5 years? And then to top it off, the fucking Super Bowl's going to be there this year.
Bonnie.
10 years. Jesus Christ. Spin, lay. So if Vegas fucks up, they won't do the full 10 years. They have to do 2 to start. Oh, yeah, that's right. The Oakland A's are moving there.
Jesus Christ.
Looks like it won't be back to Vegas for about 10 years. There's way more money in Vegas. No desire to go back to Vegas. I like Vegas a lot, but I don't want to go back anytime soon. 10 years is too long. I don't know. It was about six or seven since the last time I was out there before TwitchCon. Disney, baby. Dude, Asshole Kong Disney? I think Disney and Universal. Yeah, you got to do both. I want to wait till Super Nintendo Land's in place. Super Nintendo Land has to be in place. That's 2025. We're actually going to go to Disney, I think, in the new year before the girl turns 3 so that we can get her in free. Yeah, Super Nintendo Land will be 2025. Yeah, oh, there's one out in Cali. That's right. A friend of mine, a coworker of mine, went to the one in Cali. I want to go Halloween into December because they switched the park from Halloween to Christmas overnight, and I want to see both. Faye was just talking about wanting to do a Halloween Asshole Kong. What if we just decided to do it, the year that Super Nintendo Land opens? What if we did that? What if we did Halloween to Christmas and then go to Nintendo Land too? Maybe 2025 Asshole Kong. Let's fucking do it. Maybe we can actually talk Carrie and Suitcase into coming. Halloween Horror Nights? Yeah. Where one night it's fucking Halloween, then the very next day, everything's fucking Christmas. I knew you were going to say that, Carrion. I want to go to Star Wars too. All right, fuck it. Let's start saving now. Start saving now so we can do it right. The fuck is the Velocicoaster? The fucking Jurassic World coaster? Hello? Apparently it's fucking amazing. What up, Cronin? Oh, you know, just fucking planning out all kinds of shit. Space Door Gunner all day? Space Door Gunner. It's going to take more than a week to do everything we want. I don't think so. I think we can do most of it. I think we can make it happen. We get a multi-day park hopper pass. It was amazing. You went on a couple times with the sheets. Nice. Faye? For everybody? 4-day park hopper pass? Park hopper is where it's at. 4-day park hopper pass, you can get all the way around. See, what you do is, so if we're over six, what you do is you get the discount, you combine everything up, and then everybody just splits. Everybody splits, and that way everybody gets a discount. Because I think we'll probably have more than six people. I'll be honest.
40's big dickin'.
That military price, though. Maybe we talk Grudy into coming. We got to drink. Me and Eric have to drink around the world. I hope you understand. I'm going to be talking Mickey's big ass ear off.
Drinking around the world sold. You can do Animal Kingdom and Hollywood Studios over 2 days and hop between them as well.
Animal Kingdom's a lot of fucking fun. I do like Animal Kingdom. I feel like October to November is so good too because it's not hot as fuck. Sarver, did you ever end up going to Red Light in Orlando yet? Did you go to the bar Red Light? I know I told you about it a long fucking time ago. It's hot till November. The Red Light District. We're in the Red Light District. What's up, S'mores? What are you doing with your life, Sarver? It's perfect weather now. I mean, look, it's not going to be fucking July, August hot, right?
The weather's tolerable right now, yeah.
The Disney passes are great prices for park hoppers. Yeah, all right. Well, look at this. Look at us making plans. Look at us making plans. August is the worst. Yeah, fuck August. You know what I've always heard? Like, I know this isn't falling into line with our Halloween into fucking Christmas plans, but I've always heard the weekend of the Super Bowl is the best time to go hit the fucking parks because nobody's down there. February, nobody's there. The fucking week of the Super Bowl is no one because everybody's spent their money for the holidays. Everybody spent their money for the New Year's. It's not quite spring break yet, and clearly it's not summer.
What is the Super Bowl?
All right, Tina, now you're just trying to fuck with us. Oh, fuck being in Vegas during the Super Bowl. Ugh. We're not even talking about, we're probably talking about whatever Super Bowl happens while the fucking Super Nintendo Land is open. But no, we're looking at 2025. We'll see. We'll see what happens. I like this. I like brainstorming live in front of the fucking world. It's fucking great. Happy to be here.
Tell the whole world our plans. Yeah. No shit.
Tell everyone what's going on. Let's see here. What are we working on? What do we got? Now I have to tell everyone. I'm on my way. I'm coming in. All right. Let's do a fucking, Oh, this is a remix. Let me see what it sounds like. Let's do a fucking video. I got to use the bathroom, grab another beer, maybe a little water. We'll see. I'll play this video and then we'll be back for some more shenanigans. I don't think we're getting to Bramble tonight. Maybe just turn it to just chatting. We've been in Bramble directory all night. I don't know what the fuck to do. The fuck am I talking about? tonight, BD. How fun would it be to record a video in fucking raining blood? Neops. Fucking Neops, baby. Raining blood from a lacerated sky, yeah. Who remixed this? Power Glove remixed this. Power Glove's fucking great, by the way. They're really fucking good. Ghost did it? Ghost did what? What did Ghost do? Honestly, I like the original video a lot. The original video is really fucking good. I definitely like the original song better. Better than that remix. I still need to blast the Unicorn's vinyl on my system. I've got my fucking Unicorn cassette tape. Rhett to go. Oh, Dance Macabre. Oh, that's right. Yeah, that's right. I forgot about that. This is the original, and it's so good. They did a fucking Lost Boys shit. Sexy sax. Where's Mocked at? Where's Mocked? Sexy sax all day, baby. So Tim Capello, the fucking saxophone guy, did a show in town not that long ago, maybe about a year ago. Should have went. For Kenny G or Bill Clinton. This song is so fucking good. Honestly, I played it out for myself, though, at one point. Buffy. It's the greatest mashup of vampire shit ever. Oh, and fucking Gecko. Gordon Gecko. Gun's iconic, no shit. Sex machine. Cyberpunk Edgerunners OST. Carrion loves it. We're on there. We already switched over, Curdy. Bramble's not happening tonight. We got too busy talking about other shit. She's all right, right? She's okay. Sarver, if you haven't been playing, listening to Gunship, dude, Gunship will fucking change your life. Gunship will change your fucking life. Their last two albums, Dark All Day and Unicorn, are fucking incredible, dude. In fucking incredible. So what's the other one that we like? We like When You Grow Old, Your Heart Dies is a good one. Fucking When You Grow Old, Your Heart Dies is a solid video. And then what's the other one? We Own the Sky. So Fly for Your Life. Fly for Your Life is a really fucking good one too. I mean, we can just sit here and chill. I don't care. I don't mind. Here, let me pause that. And they lean into all this shit. The video for Fly for... Why is it so good? I don't get it. I don't fucking get it. I don't think I need to get it, but I don't get it. Like, all their shit's just awesome. They even have the Luger and the Wembley, right? Yeah, no shit, man. So fucking cool. Really cool details. Just awesome, man. They're solid. Honestly, one of the bigger groups I listen to that fucking have never toured and probably will never tour. You know what I'm saying? So the videos for Taste Like Venom and Monster in Paradise, really fucking good. I'm honestly not I am I'm a huge fan, not a fan, but I'm a huge fan of When You Grew Up, Your Heart Dies video. It's so good. Oh, it's so good. But I feel like that kind of song divides people a lot, where they're like, oh, this isn't fucking Gunship. It's really good, though. It's really awesome. The video is really good. All the fucking references, all the 80s references and stuff. Love you, Tina. Have a good night, dude. Thanks for being here. And it's a good night, guys. It's a really good night. It's a really good night. Melly. Why are there so many purple names in chat? Jesus Christ. Purple is best. It's like Grimace shake his back. Tina isn't the only booty lover. Melly, thank you so much for the tier one. Welcome to the pack. Enjoy those emotes. Enjoy those emotes. I'm a lowly affiliate, but thank you so much for spending your tier one here. I really appreciate that. It means a lot to me. We don't get much done here, but we have fun. Green is best for you. See, I'm partial to the, I've always been a turquoise, like aqua blue fan. If you can't tell from the fucking, you know, vibe of everything else in the fucking room and on the channel. So that's my name. That's why my name's that color. Curdy's always pink. I think E-Muggy is purple as well. Carrion's always been green. So is Beatty. Kane's got that fucking neon green going. Is E-Muggy green? You might be right. I think you're right. You should know. He's your husband. He's on my OBS screen. I see him. Oh, shit. Do you want to see? All right, look. Let me show you. Have you been fucking with your audio tonight, Curdy? Let's see. No?
Okay. That's how I have my audio set up, by the way. Just so you see with that plugin. What I like about that plugin is it lets you absolutely pick what you want. I only made Spotify its own source, and I made all other audio. It gives you an option to select all other audio as a source. So I just made all the other audio right there. So I did this. So capture all. I just checked this box, capture all audio except for sessions from these executables. And I just put Spotify in here. And so it captures everything but Spotify for this one audio source. And then I made this one audio source, the Twitch VOD track. I made it number 2, and I made my audio track number 1. So number 1 is my broadcast audio. Number 2 is my other audio. Yeah, it's all black now. I know. Sorry. There you go. So let's see if I can do this real quick. I don't think it's going to let me. Fuck. How do I capture this? Just this? Oh, I know how I do it. Hang on. Bam. There you go. All right. So don't worry about XP1 display. That's just the display. So I've got one. I separated this off to make it its own thing. Spotify is the only source by itself. And then this other one right here. I did capture all audio except Spotify. So that separated them right there. So all other audio and Spotify. And then I made Twitch VOD track number 2, which I made the Spotify only go to number 2. And then everything else goes to number 1 for the audio track for broadcast. That's it. Done. Tell Eric I love him. Tell Eric I love him a lot. Why isn't my shit changing? Why is it doing this? Hello?
Oh, no.
Did I fuck up? Oh, that's why I did. Okay. There we go. He worries more than he should. I want to rub them shoulders. I want to rub them fucking shoulders. Why? Oh, that's why. There you go. Anxiety is like COVID. Anyone can get it at any time, and it affects people differently. That's true. Melly, thank you again for the tier 1. That means a lot. I'm speechless. You might be the first new sub that I've had in a long fucking time. Thank you. Subbing at such a gross time in the morning. That's the real right there. I fucking love it. I love it. All right. I know what you were looking for, the midnight. I know what you were looking for.
Slow ahead. I'm gonna slow ahead.
I love this because...
Why don't you come down and chump some of this shit?
It's all fan-made fucking 80s fucking shit. Why is... Wait.
We'll get together, have a few laughs.
When you're wrong, your heart dies.
Love it.
Who cares?
I care.
I care.
There you go. Oh, hang tight. One second. Hang on. I know what's happening right now. Get rid of this real quick. Go away. That's what was fucking everything up. All right, now. Swimsuit bad shot. This song fucking gets me, man. It's good.
fucking Conan. Bunch of fucking nerds having a good time. Yeah. Couldn't imagine where I've seen that before. You people wouldn't believe.
Whatever will be, will be. Don't care what anyone else thinks.
It'll be okay. I promise.
Movies are amazing. Demetrius Mighty Mouse Johnson right there. He's a really nice dude. I met him at TwitchCon 2018.
The sun never sets on your dream.
Seems like he'd be a neat guy. He was really nice. I already want to hit that. I fucking love 80s movies. If you haven't read Ready Player One and Player Two, both really good books. If you like 80s culture shit, really good shit. Sing Into My Hairbrush. God damn. What a fun night. Turned out to be a really fucking fun night. I know we didn't play our game, but who gives a fuck? Does anyone really come here for the fucking game? Usually is when fuckery is afoot. It usually is when fuckery is afoot. You're right. Sometimes the best fun is playing with ourselves. Sometimes you gotta diddle. Muggy Tang, I love you, buddy. I am kind of excited now that there's like a small plan for 2025. I'm with Sean. Sean pointed it out to me, and I never thought about it this way. Bear Down MU. I never thought of it this way. It's always more fun when you have a thing to look forward to. When you have an event to look forward to. Like, I've got a kid coming, right? So, like, I'm looking forward to that. I'm also looking forward to 2025 when we figure out this fucking theme park thing. It's just so much better when you have a thing to look forward to. It's fucking crazy. It's fucking crazy to think about. Something about the finish line. Yeah, even going to a brewery on the weekend. Yeah. Have you seen the docu on Boogie, the YouTuber? No. What is, I don't even know who that is. What is that? Boogie? Boogie? You, specifically. You got a lot on the plate coming up. None of it sounds bad for you. I just make it work, man. I'm looking forward to all of it. School, another kid. Like, fuck it, man. Things are good. Life is good. The world is good. I'm fine with it. I got no problems, dude. I'm always down to attend the first Asshole Kong. And if I see that I can't get invited for a follow-up one. My first Asshole Kong and see if I can't get invited for a follow-up. Dude, it would be fun. It would be really fun to have you there. Boogery 2988, the guy who went from millions of subs to nothing because he spiraled. What? Boogie 2988. I'm sorry, Boogie. All right, here's a trailer. We can watch the trailer real quick. It's a sad. Did you watch the whole docu? Did you watch the whole thing? But you get an extra attention for really good news.
Man in a fucking online space that's dominated by 20-year-old kids. I'm sick. I'm old. I'm fucking dying.
Listen, let's talk about this for a second. It's not a space that's dominated by 20-something-year-old kids. There's a lot of like middle-aged people. Like, I think all the bigger streamers and all the bigger YouTubers right now, they're like late 30s and early 40s people. But it's all changing, I understand.
Wake up every day and do the same shit over and over again, expecting different results. And I never get them, but I'm just keep trying.
You started as a kid?
He's a legend on YouTube. He's been around forever. He's a fucking legend.
I thought it was one of the funniest things I'd ever seen. Like, I remember it.
What's up, ladies and gentlemen? YouTube, look at you.
I'm good at this. I can handle it. Go fuck yourself.
He's 2988.
His fall from grace is so catastrophic.
So I'm asking for your help as we head into the holidays.
I need $7,000 a month. I'm not making $7,000 a month, and I have no clue how to do it.
I made some money off of YouTube last month, but I did not make enough without a sponsor or something. Like, this is going to keep me from going out on the streets, right? Like, this is going to keep me in the house.
So, guys, can I introduce you to the love of my life?
Because I love him, and just imagining a life without him is difficult.
This is where I spend 6 to 8 hours a day trying to figure out how to save my career. My risk for stroke or heart attack is astronomical.
Okay, so that bugs me a little bit. Like, this whole thing. I need to watch it in context. Okay, I need to watch it in context. You're right.
He's guilt tripping his audience, like, and like, he kind of shames people that don't watch his videos, which brings it up multiple times.
Oh, yeah, that's real. It's real for sure. That was a ray of sunshine. Well, I need to see the context in which he's talking to her about his risk of stroke and heart attack and all this stuff. Because, like, I'm not a big fan of when people throw that in people's faces. You know what I'm saying? I'm not the biggest fan of, like, when you throw, like, your health hangups. Like, I understand if it's something that's, like, you can't help, like, that you know, you got. Like, and I'm not talking about, like, cancer and shit, but, like, I don't know. Like, that felt very much like, here, I'm going to make you cry real quick. He was a big YouTuber. Oh, he's a narcissist? Good. I mean, that's what I thought. That's what it came off like. Like, it's like, bro, that's not her fault. Why are you throwing that? I don't like when people throw shit that is controllable on the end of the person in the face of a person that is not them. Does that make sense? Groot, I'm brown, okay? Do you understand? I'm so brown that I'm brown. And I don't speak any Spanish, but I'm brown. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like making that someone else's problem. I can't understand why people do that to someone else. You a coconut. All right. Well, listen, that's beside the point. You probably speak more Spanish than me. Who was I talking to the other day that was like, I speak so much Spanish? And I was like, oh, I think it was Jack-Jack. Jack-Jack's like really, like, I don't know if she's fluent in Spanish, but Jack-Jack speaks a lot of Spanish, apparently. And I speak none. I speak negative Spanish. You lived in San Diego for 13 years? Well, yeah, you definitely speak more Spanish than me. All you got to do is fucking go out and drink. Tejas. Tejas. I can read the fuck out of a Mexican restaurant menu.
Enchiladas.
He speaks so little Spanish, Spanish people forget words when Lopez is around. I'm a black hole for Spanish words.
Chimichanga.
There's a solution for that. It's called put the fork down, go outside and walk around. I mean, look, I understand there's like shit. I don't like, I don't even care that like that someone is in bad health, right? Like as far as like by eating or whatever, but like where I get bugged and where I've always gotten bugged about anything, like, is when you make it someone else's fucking problem, right? Like, you don't hang that up on your girl, you know? Like, you don't come in and tell me, like, you don't make it my problem that you're a religious person and I'm not. That's not my fucking problem. That's your problem. Like, don't fucking evangelize. Evangelize? Is that right? Don't get all evangelical on me, you know? It's not your life. It's my life. And I would never do that to another person. I get nervous suggesting movies and TV to other people. You know what I'm saying? Putting a magnet on TV. It's tough to judge all aspects of someone else's life, but you did also put your whole self on YouTube. Yeah? Ain't nobody can dig you out of your hole but you. People can help, but you gotta hold the shovel. Yeah, I mean, that's true. Like, look, we've all had family members with problems, right? We've all had family members. Like, I've had family members and friends that were addicts, and, like, you can do what you can to help them, right? But you can't make anybody fully fucking help themselves. They can go through the motions so that you feel better, but they have to be the ones to do it for themselves, right? So to hang any of your own shit up on someone else is fucking terrible. Unless it was like some sort of abusive situation, right? Then it's absolutely on the other person. But like to hang something up on someone else that has nothing to do with how you got in that situation just feels icky. If your weight's a problem, you can't turn a clearly involved wife and go, hey, fix this problem for me. Or, hey, I'm going to die soon. I could die at any minute. Don't fuck people up like that, man. Like, that's not the fucking way to go. Can bring a horse to water. That's right, you guys. Yeah, it's like if people who say, if you break up with me and I'll harm myself. Yeah, fuck that, man. Look, man, like, that's some like high school shit, right? It doesn't make it any more fair, but it is very juvenile to hang your shit up on someone else. That's the only, like, that shit just, I pick up on that so quick. And that's why I paused it and I was like, wait a minute. Why is he saying that to her? That's like me turning to my wife and be like, I could have cancer right now and I could get really sick and die. And I don't even know it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I could, but like, why even, like, it's terrible. Had one of those just out of high school. Fuck cancer, yeah, for sure. I have a family member call me all the time for medical advice, given my career. I say exactly what to do, and they never take care of themselves and do what I said, but still call. Yep. I think the part of that is, like, they want to say they tried. Oh, I called Grudy, and she said blah, 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 and I tried. And it's like, playing, they're still sick. Yeah, I'm 51. I got, like, 20 high school friends that are gone now, and every time we hear about one of our homies passing, It hits a little harder. It does. It's really frustrating. It really is. Some people want to hear the truth. Others want to hear the convenient truth. Well, absolutely, things are easier said than done, right? It's really hard. Like, food can be a drug for a lot of people. Sugar can be a drug for a lot of people. Like, I'm not saying it's easy, but don't blame people. You know what I'm saying? I don't even know if was the music even playing at that point? Is it mute? Was the music playing that whole time? It was, right? Am I wrong? It was muted. Okay, sweet. I feel like an asshole. Okay, did the audio for the fucking trailer work? It did, right? Chemically Good has addicting. Dude, I just have to look at my 2.5-year-old. Dude, around Halloween time? Oh my God. I'm so, like, we have to, like, clear out the fucking bucket. Like, it's like a Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde type situation with the fucking candy. It's fucking crazy. She goes crazy. And when you tell her no, you think it's like, and she just crumbles to the ground. And you're like, what the fuck? So we have to do a fucking detox. A detox. Religion and sugar. I hear you. I hear you on that. That's for sure. I don't know. That's the thing that just something that bugged me. Damn. There are Native Africans that the worst thing that ever introduced them when the white man gave them sugar. They said it made them weak physically and mentally. Give my cat insulin. Speaking of sugar, lol. Grudy, have a great night. We're closing it up right now. You're not missing anything. We're calling it a night. Thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate it. Love you very much. Have a great night. Good night, group. Thank you. Love you. All right, guys. We're going to call it a night here. It's almost 11 Eastern. I think we did a good job tonight. We did almost 3 hours, right at 3 hours of goodness, just chatting and fucking bullshitting and memeing ourselves and trying to get Curdy to do shit. I call that a success. I'm going to go watch my son's plane on FlightAware. All right, Sarver. Have a great night. I got to say thank you to Melly for subscribing tier one. I really fucking appreciate that. 24 months tier two from Sergeant Sexy. Mod Kerps showing up out of nowhere. 40 months. Good fucking God. Holy shit. I really appreciate all of you for being here. I fucking love you guys so much. And I hope you have a wonderful rest of your week. And I can't wait to see you on Sunday. All right. Much love. I will catch you guys on Sunday. Maybe we'll do Bramble. Maybe not. I don't know. Either way, have a great night. Carrion, thank you. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, later, mid. 4, hope your boy gets good. 3,